Hey guys, so for today's video we are going to be doing a tutorial on this look, and we will be talking about the Daisy Marquez palette. If you guys are interested, please keep on watching. So when you first take it out of the box, this is the actual box it comes in, and this is the actual palette. You already know it's a magnetized palette. I haven't seen this ever before. I think that's her idea, to create something unique. You place it here and you have yourself a vanity mirror, and you can literally just do that as well. So I think that was very creative and very unique. I think the thing that stands out the most for me is the Tiffany blue, because most of your palettes will give you that pop of yellow, pop of orange, but they won't give you that pop of Tiffany blue. And I've seen so many pretty looks that I was so excited to get it, and you guys are probably getting all the looks coming up are probably gonna be Tiffany blue. I'm just kidding. No, but I thought it was a great pop of color, and the fact is that it's her, so that's what makes it even more special. I think that this palette is very motivational for me and a lot of us that have seen Daisy from the start, and to see that she has her own palette now, and it was her dream come true. So this is something else that is included in the packaging, and I'll just read it to you guys. I'm so excited to finally share my palette with you all. To my flowers who have been there with me since the beginning, this one's for you. I almost cried when I read it the first time. I've worked so hard to bring forth this palette, and each color has been created with you all in mind. Can't wait to see all the magic that you create with it. Love you always, Daisy Marquez. I'm not kidding. Okay, so as far as the pigment, you guys will see I'm gonna dip into colors, but it is very pigmented. Dream. Ooh. I'm also excited about this slime color, and well, I love burgundy, so of course, and yellow. She gives you that perfect amount of transition shades and your pop of color and your shimmers that you could create those elegant looks with. Okay you guys, so we are gonna get started using the Daisy palette. First we are going to go into the shade Dulce, and we are basically just gonna use that as our transition shade slash setting. I want you guys to take a look at this pigment. Look at that. I'm impressed because that was obviously the first shade that I went into, and I am just applying this on the crease. We're gonna go into the shade Bittersweet. I'm applying this right here. Y'all could see pigment is there, and for the price point that we're getting all these bomb shades, and I've always liked BH Cosmetics, so I had no doubt in my mind that it was gonna be a good palette. Not popping today. What can you do? Next, we are gonna go into the shade Cocoa. That's definitely what I would have named that shade if it was my palette. What am I like? Hot chocolate cocoa. Brown shade. Look at that. That we're just applying. Let's see that fallout. See any as far as on the brush, which I think is important. On the palette you see a little bit, but only for certain colors, which like I said, if you could see the payoff on your eyes, to me that's all that matters. Okay, so we're applying that brown here, kind of smoking out those corners. I think you guys have seen me do a spotlight eye so many times that probably already know or most of the process, but if not, we're gonna do it together anyway. So we just wanna make sure it doesn't look muddy. And to avoid it looking muddy, don't apply too much. Build it up if you're new at it. And if you do apply too much, clean your brush and blend it out. Just keep cleaning your brush and blend what's already there. And you should be straight. We're gonna take concealer. We're gonna cut the crease with this ABH brush. We're going to focus it on the center. above my crease. The shade Daisy, Tiffany Blue shade. Right now I'm focused on just setting everything. If anything, this one is the one that has the most fallout, but I get it because it's a minty color. And then you could just build it up. Now that we're talking about it, I cut this crease really bad, but since we're gonna fix it, I'm gonna go in with a little detail brush. We're gonna go back into the shade Cocoa. We're just gonna go in that crease area and kind of clean it up. And at the same time, it intensifies everything, so we just blend it out. And now we can actually focus on smoking it out. And there's no color to mend the two together, the Daisy and the Hot Cocoa. We are just gonna carefully go into Cocoa and blend that towards the center. So like that. You can see I'm starting towards the end, so all the product is being deposited to the end, and then what's left of it is getting put into that transition between the two. So today's lashes are going to be Lashes Boss by De Amor Lashes. Let me take it out to show it to you guys. It is already on this eye. So these eyelashes are a medium length, not too dramatic. I basically think they're pretty good for anyone. I like to apply the lower lash line after my face is done already. So I'm doing that now. Urban Decay Concealer. Apply some Sephora Micro HD foundation. Bronzer from Tarte, Princess Avenue. Just apply it right there, right here, and right here, because I got a big ol' forehead. There we go. And then just kind of smooth everything over with this. Today I don't feel like wearing highlighter, so going to just a whole matte look. Cocoa and Bittersweet. We're just gonna apply that in the lower lash line. In our corner, we are going to use the shade Dream and the shade Icy. Gonna apply Dream first. Right here. Second, I got scared of like, hello, Dream, where are you? Then I'm gonna apply Icy. So, just really making that inner corner pop. Okay, now to keep everything in place, I'm gonna use my Morphe setting spray. Let's set it in. Learn this tip from Daisy. So just alone with the colors that we use, I'm very satisfied with the palette. I feel that it is very pigmented and you get what you're paying for. You get 20 shades for 20 bucks, a dollar. And it's worth it. It's not just some cheap palette. It was created with love. You could see it, you can tell. And it's affordable. I love that she went with an affordable brand. A good affordable brand. Okay, you guys, so thank you for watching my video. I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial. Let me know in the comments down below, and thanks for watching.